Welcome to another edition of Great Health, Abundant Happiness, and Outrageous Love. Mwah. We thought we'd do another video on twin flames and, I guess, twin flame separation and the confusion around that. I'm just going to tell a quick story and we'll kind of feed in from there.
Perfect.
So I saw, you know, all these people out on Facebook and some groups, and they're talking about these toxic relationships, and there are others on there telling that the twin flames, and it's pretty dangerous, really, because if you're in an abusive, toxic relationship and someone's telling you that's your twin flame and you believe them, you're going to like really work hard to make this toxic, abusive relationship work. I mean, that's scary to me as, right. as I see some of this. So I was kind of going through YouTube and looking at some of this, and there was a gentleman who had this whole thing about twin flames is not real and it's a bunch of crap, and he's going on. And I just respectfully said, you know, we didn't know anything about it. Karen and I met, and years went by, and then we heard about twin flames. We checked all the boxes, and I said, it's really a beautiful journey. And it was really funny because he got back to me and said, Jeffrey, you're absolutely right. This was an old video, and it was about a year ago. I was just really angry about a shitty relationship I had. So I got a kick out of it. We've kind of traded a bunch of messages back and forth, and I think we'll, you know, be friends out there. But it's interesting, and the reason why I share the story is, you know, there are a lot of people that are just angry about something or a relationship, and, you know, they're calling it a twin flame separation, and I think it's really dangerous.
Well, I think it is. And just to clarify, on this particular YouTuber, he came back around, right? And didn't he acknowledge that it was not a twin flame
relationship? He said it was just, this is an old video. It was a shitty relationship, is what he said. Now he said he's with his twin flame. I don't want to give too much away because it's like personal conversation I had with him. But it was just kind of funny.
Right. Well, I was just getting to the point of, you know, he's a great, this guy's actually got some really great content out there. And what I really respect is when somebody puts a video out there, and I think we've all probably done it, where we put some information out there and then maybe we've learned something different or something new, or we've had an experience and realized that what we initially put out it has changed, or our view has changed on it, etc. But the point of this particular video...
Yeah, because this isn't just about an old video that I just use as an example. Yes. This is like really prevalent right now.
Right,
a lot of people
right,
are talking
exactly.
about this. This is not just an old
having
video
nothing
story.
To do with this YouTuber. Right. This is Jeffrey and I are in all of these Facebook groups and social media groups about twin flame separation, the runner, the chaser. And as he said, when we started dating, you know, we had this amazing connection. And we always knew that it was something different than anything we'd ever experienced before from the minute, you know, that we got together. And for us, the way that we understand, and when he says we check off the boxes, you know, that's an interesting concept too, because some of the boxes out there we're not checking, because some of the boxes out there are not a twin flame. And that is really one thing we want to talk about and help you dispel, because as Jeffrey said, it's extremely dangerous what's going on in social media right now with twin flames and people labeling relationships as twin flames because, oh, you know, I met this person and everything was great, and when we look at each other, there's this magic and we got together and it was just, you know, something so astronomical. And now he's blocking me or she's blocking me and he's with a karmic or she's with a karmic.
Well, even worse, it's like, you know, there's restraining orders and people are going through divorce and people have kids and they're living in different relationships and different family. I mean, it's just, it's pretty deep. So people are kind of terming themselves a twin flame coach, and it's really just marriage counseling. But the dangerous part, and this is me, what do I know? We learned about twin flames just, a year or two ago. But it's a twin flame, if you go look at the definition, I mean, you only got one if there's one in this life. And you basically come together, you're attracted.
Right.
But people that are these coaches...
And we also don't believe that everybody has a twin flame. We believe everyone has a soulmate.
But the danger is if someone's telling you that's your twin flame and it's a toxic, abusive relationship and you're duped into thinking, oh my God, this is my one and only, I have to make this work, and it's dangerous.
Yeah.
I mean, dangerous for your psyche, it could even be physical, but it's terrible.
Right. I mean, it's so concerning to us because... we see these people out here that are, you know, these twin flame coaches that will get involved in these conversations. You know, somebody is basically, you know, talking about a relationship where someone's blocked them or mentally abused them, or, you know, they're so low and distraught because they're not with this person, but yet they're living as if they are. It's like, you find out, I'm not with my twin flame in the 5D, only in the 3D. You know, people, you need to hit reality and understand that every relationship is not a twin flame relationship. And by putting things into a bucket, like, because I can't stop thinking of him or her, or I have these dreams, or I see these numbers, or I saw a psychic, this is my favorite. I saw a psychic and she told me this was my twin flame, or I was gonna meet my twin flame. And now you're working with a twin flame ascension coach who is helping you to power through your issues and do your mirroring exercises so that you can connect with your twin flame. This is extremely dangerous, what's going on out there. These twin flame coaches are not qualified doctors to help you with this, and neither are we.
Well, and this isn't everybody, because as you start talking about mirroring and things like that, there's a lot of great tactics out there.
Yes.
But the issue is, we're talking about people who are in separation, twin flame separation.
Right.
It's a toxic relationship, and they're applying all this stuff to that toxic relationship. So,
people are telling them that they should continue on that path.
I guess so. And when, I want to make sure people are clear. I mean, you and I are very spiritual, so when you talk about all of this stuff, we're into it, and there's a lot of good out there too. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I guess specifically, I just want to talk about twin flame separation. How people are terming a toxic relationship with twin flame.
Right.
I mean, there's a lot of great mirroring exercises. There's a lot of great psychics out there. People have
abilities. Absolutely.
We have some friends who have abilities that are unexplainable.
I wasn't coming down on psychics. What I'm saying is that, you know, people will take all this information and build a case. It's almost like you have to mentally build a case that this is your twin flame, because if you really look deep down within, this person is not giving you love. They're not unconditionally loving you. In fact, they're making you feel miserable. You're allowing that to happen.
Right.
And you're very unhappy. We're talking about this group of people that have such an immense feeling of pain. That pain is a very low vibration. Means that your energies are really low and negative. And when you're in love, when you meet your twin flame, your energy explodes. You're already vibrating at a high vibrational.
It's the opposite end of the scale. Yes.
Exactly.
Right.
And people don't understand. And not only that, other people will tell the people, they don't understand, or, you know, we need to go through this because, you know, we need to allow ourselves to get fixed and them to get fixed during this running and chasing. Stop. That's not it. That's just not a twin flame relationship. And your person will come around, but not when you have kept yourself down here in this low vibration of negativity, of basically stalking a person's Facebook page and maybe stalking their, you know, boyfriend or girlfriend or husband or wife's Facebook page as well. You are living not in the reality of time, but you're living in a kind of a sociopathic world, because you're living through all these social media, this information that you're gathering and putting together and creating in your mind based on a relationship that you've also created in your mind. And our only goal here is to help you to release that. And here's the big thing. If this person truly is your twin flame, if you are really set that they 100% are, and they need time and you need time to heal and you'll come together, release them completely. When Jeffrey and I met, it was a random, you know, brief random meeting. And I always say, had we gotten together then, you know, we wouldn't have stayed together. We would have come back together. But we already knew it's the way the universe works. We were twin flames and we're like magnets. Because neither one of us was ready, you get repelled in the magnetic force, because the universe doesn't want you to be together until you're ready to accept and receive and give that 100% bulletproof, unconditional love.
Yeah, this is really simple. When Karen talks about being ready, you have to first have self-love. And people that are battling down at these low vibrations, I mean, there's not a lot of self-love there, self-esteem, right. And no, some of the things I see, it's really terrible. It's sad. So, when we first met, we weren't looking for anybody else. We weren't ready, but it was just, we met in a line at Christmas shopping.
Yep.
And then it was 3 years later where Karen approached me in a crowd and just, recognized me kind of a thing. And then we were ready at that period of time. And, we met, and 6 months later we were engaged, and 6 months later after that we were married. And that was 30 years ago. But so it was a beautiful journey. So we're just here really to share some of this. And we're happy to answer questions. We talk to a lot of people offline. I mean, we feel our divine mission is really to help people.
Right.
Again, all we're doing, we're not doctors.
Nope.
I studied psychology, but that doesn't mean anything. It's like, we're not doctors. We're just sharing our experiences and our knowledge of 30 years of relationship. So, and by the way, we don't have a course you have to sign up for. We're not charging people hourly rates or any of that stuff. So this isn't our business. But it's, we see it out there, and it's just enough that we had to talk about this again. And it's a warning to people that have put themselves in a really bad place, thinking that this is their one and only in this life, and they have to make this work, and it's abusive. That's the part that I don't like to see.
Right, and you're losing days upon days because you're stuck down here in this vibration. And I want to say, as Jeffrey said, 3 years later, when we happened to randomly be at the same place again, and there was a sea of people. And I don't believe that I just spotted him. I believe the universe brought us together because we were ready. And that's the way it works with the twin flame. So this separation, there was no running and chasing. You're separated because that's the natural order of the way things go in the universe when you're not ready. When that magnet isn't pulling you together because it's not ready. So therefore, you're separated, but your lives have nothing to do with each other during this separation.
Right. But again, you're talking about twin flames.
Right, and that's what I'm saying is these people that are they're obsessed with this other person's life and their life with them.
Right.
That's not how separation in the twin flame union works. And as Jeffrey said, we're not doctors, but if you were going to go to a marriage counselor, would you want to go to a marriage counselor that's never been married or that's currently divorced or that is on a multiple marriage and maybe still rocky? Or would you want a marriage counselor that has experienced a very long, successful marriage? And that doesn't mean that we haven't had bumps in the road. That means that we have learned the secrets to nurture and continue to nurture what we have so that it flourishes and it becomes stronger and more beautiful and more, outrageously sexy every single day. And that's the advice that we feel we have to share. It's not medical, it's not professional, but it's from real experience, from our hearts.
And again, be careful here. We don't want to line up people up. This is not our business.
Right.
Yeah, we're basically just doing a video on the facts.
Right.
Maybe your operators are standing by. You're ready to take all these people on. But this is just something I want to throw out there. I mean, we're not in the business of really counseling. We want to help people when they come to us and have questions. But I have to clarify,
No, exactly. And we do feel our divine mission is, because we've been so lucky to, have this twin flame union during this lifetime, we want to share with everyone that we can just the possibility of outrageous, beautiful, magnificent love, because that just raises the entire vibration of the universe for all of us.
Well,
right?
I like your tagline, great health, abundant happiness, outrageous love. This twin flame thing is just one of the pillars. There's so many other things that we share on this channel. If you guys watch these videos, you know, we're all about traveling, living our best life. You know, we build residual income to fund this kind of stuff, and not with anything around what we're talking about here. It's a technology business that we have.
Right.
We have a lot of things going on. We plant-based, you know, we're helping people with their health, whether it be to lose weight or get off of, prescribed drugs, that kind of thing. So we're out here trying to share how to live your best life. And
right.
This twin flame thing just happens to be one of those pillars, one of the many things that we talk about.
Right.
Right.
And I think we'll do a couple more videos on it, just because we really want to get across to people that for those of you who are experiencing what you're terming the twin flame separation, the running and the chasing, please watch this video twice. And then take a look. We did an entire series on self-sabotage, and I think there's a real correlation between those who are in that, I don't even like the word false twin flame, because there's no such thing as a false twin flame. You either have a twin flame or you don't. There's no false twin flame. That is one's mind's fabrication of a relationship that doesn't exist. So, take a look at some of those self-sabotage videos that we did, because, you know, those were really heartfelt, and I think they can really help some of the people that are, you know, vibrating down low to change it. Our whole goal is for you to vibrate up here where we are in love at 520 and peace and joy even higher. You know, it's a beautiful life, and it's very short time that we have here on earth to have these experiences, and they need to be beautiful, and we want you to have beautiful experiences. Wishing you great health, abundant happiness, and outrageous love from the Nest at Copper Mountain.
Thanks for listening, guys.